Hi everybody, welcome back to our class. Please subscribe Model Maths Nagarasar YouTube channel if you like my videos and click bell button, share with your friends. Okay, today in this class we are going to learn Intermediate Second Year Mathematics 2A 5th chapter Permutations and Combinations. Part 3. In part 1 we have learned that this introduction and some formulas. And in part 2, we completed 19 very short questions. So 20th onwards and up to 30, we have only 30 very short questions from this chapter. So 20th question is, there are 5 copies each of 4 different books. Then find the number of ways of arranging these books arranged in a shelf. So how can we do this? See, what is the given information? There are 5 copies, each of 4 different books. So let I am taking, what are the 4 different books? A, B, C, D are 4 different books. 4 different books. See, each different book is 5 copies. So, given that, mention that each book is 5 copies, is 5 copies, that means the total books are, so becomes what, each book is 5 copies, so A is, how many books are, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 books, and B is also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. C is also 3, 4, 5. D is also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are the books we have. 4 different books and each book is 5 copies. So very simple answer. In the part 1 we did how to arrange the number of ways of the word, engineering, MSET. So like that. Intermediate, mathematics, permutation. Okay, how did we solve that one? Same as value. How many numbers are there completely? 1, 2, 3, 4, 20. So, the number of, see here, moreover, how many A's are there? So, total books is called 20. So, in number of books A's, number of A's, A's also 5, B books also 5 copies, C books also 5 copies, D books also 5 copies. Therefore, total number of ways, what is the formula? Simply, n factorial by p factor into q factor into r factor, like that. Here, total number of books 20. So, we get 20 factorial by, each book is again 5 times. 5 factorial into, 5 factorial into, 5 factorial into, 5 factorial. Okay? In part 1, these type of questions, so I think 5 or 6 are completed. In single step, you can write the answer. So, I did some steps which are useful to solve the problem. Is it clear? So, very simple. 4 different books, each 5 copies. Means, 4, 5, 20 books totally. So, each book 5 copies means, A repeated 5 times. Means, 5 times 5 times 5. So, directly we can write the answer in the MSET type or computer exams type exam. Okay? Now, let us see the next question. Please note down. Next, see the question 21st. Find the number of ways arranging the word triangle so that the relative positions of vowels and consonants are not disturbed. See, what is the word is given? Triangle. Okay, in this, what are the vowels and what are the consonants? T consonant, R consonant, I vowel, A vowel, N consonant, G consonant, L consonant, E vowel. I think we know A E I O U are the vowels, the remaining are consonants. So here we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are consonants, 1, 2, 3 are vowels, okay, How many consonants are there? Number of consonants is equal to 5 and the number of vowels is equal to 3. See here, these are very interesting sums. Okay, na? Just simply we can write answers. If you complete this chapter, you can feel very enjoying. So happily you can feel because of very interesting chapter this is. Okay, 4 marks questions gives more interested and very easy problems. 4 marks questions and very important 4 marks questions are there. Same type of questions are there. So let's watch in the next part for 4 marks. Now let us see. Here T, R, N, G, M, 5 are consonants. These 5 can be replaced in their replaces without disturbing vowels. We can in 5 letters in 5 ways. Sorry, 5 letters in 5 places. How many ways we can write? See, 5 consonants in 5 places. 5 places can be arranged in how many ways? 5 T5 ways. That means 5 factorial ways. Very simple. Similarly, you can write your second statement. Yes, very good. Vowels 3 are there. So 3 vowels in 3 places. How many places? 3 places. 3 vowels, 3 places can be arranged. Now tell me, can be arranged in how many ways? Very good. 3P3 ways. 3P3 ways means what? 3 factorial ways. And after that, the final answer is, so therefore total number of ways is equal 5 factorial into 3 factorial. This is the answer. Okay, based on fundamental principle, in part 1 I gave you what is fundamental principle. Simply, if your work done in m ways and the second work done in n ways, the complete work one after other can be done in m into n ways. That is 5 factorial into 3 factorial ways. This is the answer. Okay, don't write 5 into 3, 15, 15 factorial don't write. 5 factor means 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. 3 factor means 3 into 2 into 1. If you are interested, simplify that. But if you write up to here, okay, you can award it 2 marks completely. This is the solution. Very easy or not? Okay, let us see this type of some more problems. 22nd question. Find the number of 4 letters words that can be formed using the letters of the word piston, in which at least one letter will be repeated. In which one letter will be repeated. See, first of all, we have to find 4 letters word. But given the letters in the word, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 letters are given. Okay, if repeated is not mentioned, then simply we can write 6 letters in 4 letters word. 6P4 ways is the answer. 6P4 is the answer. But here, one letter is repeated. At least one letter is repeated. So means, repeated means we have a formula. I remember you. That is n power r. N power r. Okay. Two formulas are there. When repeated is allows, then the number of ways is n power r. Or n letters are there, the number of 4 letters word can be arranged in npr ways. See, here repeated and at least one letter. At least one letter repeated means n power r minus npr. Okay, this is a special problem. So important problem for 2 marks question. Okay, this is only think difficulty. The remaining are very simple. Okay, given what? Given that, so what is the word? Piston. So how many number of letters? Number of letters is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. That implies n equal to 6. So next number of four letters word. So required four letters word. That means or small r can be taken as four. So what is formula? Formula is number of words at least one letter is repeated. Is the formula is n power r minus ntr. So that implies, that means what here? 6 power r minus ntr means 6pr. R means what? 4. So here also you can write r means 4. So this is the answer. 6 power 4 minus 6p4 is the answer. 2 marks question. Is it clear? This is the formula. We just remember this formula. When one letter is, at least one letter is repeated, immediately we should remember the formula is n power r minus npr. N means the number of letters in the word, r means how many letters are asking. That's it. Okay, shall we go to next problem?
Okay.
Next, 23rd question. Find the number of 5 letters words that can be formed using the letters of the word nature, so that begins with the capital N when repetition is allowed. See, here the word is given nature. So how many letters are there? And especially in that, the first letter begin with the capital N, that is fix, and the remaining letters 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 are there. Okay, so nature, A, T, U, R, B, this is the word. So here N must be in first place. So this can be done in 1 factorial, am I right? In one place, one letter, 1p1 means 1 factorial. The remaining, how many letters? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 letters. Remaining 5 letters let's see here. Sorry, we should find the 5 letters word. So I have to take, first letter should be N, the remaining 1, 2, 3, 4. These 4 boxes should be filled by remaining all 6 letters when repetition is allowed. So here 4 letters should be arranged. Totally how many letters are there? 6 letters, 3, 4, 5, 6, by 6 letters, and mention that repetition is allowed. So this can be done in n power r, am I right? N power r ways. If repetition is not mentioned, then we can write 6p4 ways. But here completely we should find the number of 5 letters word. In that, first one must be N, then remaining 4 letters we should fix, we should fill the box by using 6 letters. When repetition is allowed, then formula is N power R. So the number of ways are 6 power R. So 6 power 4 into 1 means how much? 6 power 4. Therefore, number of ways, finally answer is number of ways when repetition is allowed is 6 power 4 ways. So this is the answer. Okay, let us see the next problem. Next, 24th question. Find the number of ways of selecting 3 vowels and 2 consonants from the letters of the word equation. See, till now we have done the questions about arranging means permutations. Selecting means what? Combinations. Means in this problem solutions, we can get NCR formula we should use. Okay. So what is the word? Given that the word is equation. In this how many consonants are there, how many vowels are there. Okay, vowels, what are the vowels? E, U, A, I, O. Okay, E, U, A, I, O. So completely how many vowels are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 vowels are there. Next, see the consonants from the word. Okay, from the word consonants are Q, T, N. That's it. U, T, N. So three consonants are given and three vowels are given in the given word. So now we should find the number of ways of selecting three vowels from five vowels. Okay, that is one concept. And we should select two consonants from given three consonants. So now how many ways we can write? Let us see. Three vowels out of five vowels can be selected in how many ways? Here n is 5 or is 3. 5C3 ways. So 5 vowels are given. In that 5 vowels we should select only 3 vowels. That can be done in 5C3 ways. Okay, next, similarly we should select two consonants out of three consonants can be selected in how many ways? We should select only two consonants out of three consonants. That means 3C2 ways. Okay, in the question, selecting is mentioned. That means it is a combinations. In combinations, we should use C. In arrangements, we should use P. So, finally, by using fundamental theorem, therefore, the number of ways is equal 5C3 into 3C2. This is the answer, finally. Okay, up to here, then you can be awarded full marks. No need to simplify again. Even if you are interested, you can simplify and write the answer. But up to here, you must present in the answer sheet. Same type of question. I think you can solve this question. Just pause the video and do it the problem. Then after you can verify with me. That is, find the number of ways of selecting 3 girls and 3 boys out of 7 girls and 6 boys. So here completely given 7 girls and 6 boys. And we should select 3 girls from 7 girls. So we should select 3 girls out of 7 girls. So in how many ways we can select? Very good. 7C3 ways. Similarly, 6 girls, 6 boys are given. 6 boys are given. Out of the 6 boys, we should select only 3 boys. So, selecting 3 boys out of 6 boys. So, that can be done in 6C3 ways. Am I right? So, 3 boys out of 6 boys can be selected in 6C3 ways. So, total number of selections, fundamental principle, product of these two, n into n, means 7C3 into 6C3 is the answer. That's it. 1, 2, 3, 4 steps enough. Okay? See the next problem. See next question. 26. Find the number of ways of arranging 4 boys and 3 girls around a circle so that all the girls sit together. Okay? I just recall you few points. One is the number of ways in a line, that is NPR formula. When repetitions are, the formula is N4R. When at least one repetition, then the formula is N4R minus NPR. See, we must remember these formulas. The number of arrangements, NPR formula. Repetitions are allowed, then arrangements, N4R formula. When the arrangements at least one repetition is allowed, the formula is M4R minus NPR. Next, number of selecting of so and so words, the formula is NCR. Okay. Next, the number of arrangements in a circle, the formula is N minus 1 factorial. The formula is N minus 1 factorial. Next, the number of arrangements of a of chains or beads like garlands, so that kind of formulas N minus 1 factorial by 2. Is it here? This is for selection. This is formula used for in a round table or circle. This used for garlands. Okay. This will be used in the problems. See here also, the number of ways arranging of 4 boys and 3 girls. So totally we have given that 4 boys and 3 girls. We should arrange them in a circle, means around a circle. Means in a circle we should arrange. Here what is the condition? So that all girls sit together. How many girls are there? 3 girls are there. So 3 girls we should sit together. Means girl 1, girl 2, girl 3. So in this way we should arrange. The remaining are boys. There is no specific condition to sit together. Means individually they can be seated. So B3. How many boys are there totally? 4 boys. So got it, 4 boys. See, girls, 3 girls sit together. That's why 3 girls are taken in a single box. So now these 3 can be arranged themselves in how many ways? 3P3 ways, means 3 factorial ways. And if you consider this is 1 unit and boy 1 second unit, this is 3rd unit, this is 4th one, this is 5th unit. So totally 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 units. These 5 units can be arranged in how many ways? 5P5 ways, that is 5 factorial ways. So see, 1 by 1. Condition is girls sit together. So 3 girls have themselves can be arranged in 3P3 ways, means 3 factorial ways. So girls are completed. Now 3 girls are treated. 3 girls treated as one unit and remaining how many boys are there? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 boys individually, because there no need to sit together. So individually 4 boys has 4 units. So total how many ways? Total 3 girls as 1 unit and 4 boys as 4 units, totally 5 units. So totally 5 units in a circle can be arranged in how many ways? N minus 1 factorial, means 5 minus 1 factorial, so becomes 4 factorial. So 3 girls themselves 3 factorial, 5 units by using 3 girls as one condition and remaining 4 boys as 4 units, totally 5 units. 5 units can be done in 5 minus 1 factorial, means 4 factorial. So therefore finally answer is the number of ways is equal 3 factorial into 4 factorial. 3 factorial into 4 factorial. Okay, for more explanation you just watch the 4 marks problems. In that the specific explanation also given very clearly. So please watch 4 marks videos, then you can get better clarity if you have any confusion in these 2 marks questions. Okay, next you take the next question. 27th. Find the number of different chains that can be created using 7 different color beads. Just now I told you the formula is for garlands or chains of beads, those type of questions, n minus 1 factorial by 2. So here n is what? 7. So what is the answer? 7 minus 1 whole factorial by 2. This is the answer. So 6 factorial by 2 is the answer simply. Okay. So what is the solution? Given that 7 different color beads. 7 different color beads. So the number of pairs of beads, chains of beads, chains of beads is 7 minus 1 whole factorial by 2, that is 6 factorial by 2. That's very simple answer. Okay, that's why you remember formulas. Once again, I'm remembering you. One is number of permutations, number of ways, NPR formula. If n values replace by n numbers, that means NPN, in that we use simply n factorial. When repetition is allowed, then we use NPR formula. This is for repetition, this is for arrangements, and at least one repetition. When the question mentioned that at least one repetition, then we use n power r minus NPR formula. Next to selection. In the selection, we have to use NCR formula. Then, and coming to here, extension of this formula. When around a circular table arc, we use n minus 1 factorial circular table in a circular way. And the number of beads is mentioned, we use n minus 1 factorial by 2. So, okay, na? Chains of beads, like that formulas are there. So, let us see the next question. See, last two, three problems, 28, 29, 30, then our two mass questions are completed through these three problems. Before that, just write down a small note. That is, first one, the number of bidirections is equal to n factorial. Please note down, the number of bidirections is equal to n factorial. So that's why the number of bidirections by using the 7 elements answer is what? 7 factorial. That's it. This is the answer. Next, second formula, the number of injections from set A to set B. The number of injections from set A to set B is n of B P n of A. N of B means what? Number of elements in set B. N of A means what? Number of elements in set A. So that is the formula. Next, your third formula note down. The number of positive divisors is equal to alpha 1 plus 1 into alpha 2 plus 1 into alpha 3 plus 1 into dash dash, where alpha 1, alpha 2, alpha 3 are prime powers. Prime powers. Please note down these 3 points. So, used on these 3 points, the question 28 one can be solved. Find the number of bidirections of set A containing 7 elements on A. See, the number of elements, means n can be taken as 7. So, therefore, the number of bidirections, is equal to n factorial, that is equal 7 factorial. Completed. Answer. Next, see the next 29th question. So, very simple questions. Find the number of injections from set A containing 4 elements to the set B containing 6 elements. Here, set A containing 4 elements, set B containing 6 elements. That means n of A equal to 4 and n of B means set B containing 6 elements. This is the given information. Therefore, number of injections from set A to set B is what is the formula? N of B P N of A. So which is equal to what is N of B means number of elements in B? 6. 6 P P N of A means 6 P 4. This is the answer. Is it clear? So now the last question, 30th question is, Find the number of positive divisors of 1018. To find the number of positive divisors, first of all we should find the what are the prime factors. So we can simplify with the two table, 2 5 are 2 4 are 2 0 are 2 2 are 2 7 are 0. Next, in 3 table we can write 3 9 are, in 3 table again 3 3 are, in 3 table again 3 10 are, in 2 table equals 2 5 are. So 1018 means 2 into 3 into 5. How many 2's are there? 1, 2, 3. 2 power 3 into how many 3's? 1, 2, 3. 3 power 3 into 5. How many 5's? 5. So here, what is the prime power? Alpha 1 is 3 and alpha 2 is 3 and alpha 3 is 1. Therefore, number of positive divisors. What is the formula? Alpha 1 plus 1 into alpha 2 plus 1 into alpha 3 plus 1. This is the formula. So substitute in that. So I am removing these formulas. So which is equal? What is alpha 1? 3. So 3 plus 1 into 3 plus 1 into alpha 3 by 1. 1 plus 1. How much? 3 plus 1? 4. 3 plus 1? 4. 1 plus 1, 2. So 4 into 4, 16, 16 into 2, 32. So 32 positive divisors we can get for 1018. So these problems, 2 mass problems, of course you may get feel some difficulty about remembering the formulas, where we can, which formula we have to use like that. So don't worry about that. You just recall all formulas every time, means what is the arrangements formula, NPR, what is the number of ways when n numbers are given in the n ways, that is NPN, that is called n factorial ways. Simply NPN place we use n factorial formula. For circular, n minus 1 factorial. For selection, NCR. For repetition alone, n power r. One repetition is allowed at least, n power r minus NPR. Okay, for garlands, chains or beads, like that, n minus 1 factorial by 2, and bilection n factorial, injections n of b, p, n of a, and number of positive divisors, alpha 1 plus 1 into alpha 2 plus 1 into alpha 2. Just these are the formulas in this combination formation. All formulas I revised, just only 5-6 are there. You must remember those formulas, and after that solve these 2 mass questions. And these 2 mass questions not only for this intermediate scoring purpose and subject purpose, not only that, in another competitive purpose also it is useful, like MCET or in another exams, means banking exams, SI constable, in that exams also these problems are useful. So next, in the next part we can start 4 mass questions, very important 4 mass questions I will teach in the starting. So those are very interestingly, how to find a rank of the world, how to form a cricket team when some 7 bowlers, 6 batsmen, 2 wicket keepers are given, like that. So we can form the cricket team. So very interesting problems are there. So please watch next video for getting more videos. First of all, please subscribe and click bell button. Thank you.